Hey Brewmunchers, it's Zombie Girl here, back with another Project Zomboid video. So today we're going to go over some car basics. These are for noobs or people that just don't know what the heck's going on and maybe want to see if there's some information they don't know yet. So let's hop right into this video. When you first see a car, you may find that it's unlocked and you may want to smash the window open. But this isn't a good option because you can get hurt and you'll call the local zombies over. So if you happen to find the key, you can just hop right in. And when you do, you'll see a very cool HUD that has so many options, like putting the key in the ignition, turning on the AC, playing with the lights, turning the engine off and on, but also locking the doors and locking the trunk and unlocking them. You can start your car by just hitting W and scootalooing your boot out of there if like zombies saw you. Another way to interact with the car is to press V in the car, and you'll get this radial menu with so many options, including the ability to change the seat, which is important if you get in through the back seat and you want to get to the front seat, or if you're in the front seat and some Zeds are coming after you through that door. Now, if you want to start the car without the key, you have the option of hotwiring it if you have one electrical and two mechanical skills. However, this is probably a bad idea in multiplayer because anyone can start your car up. A really cool another option we have with cars is that you can actually use the seats in the car to store bags or really store anything. You can throw all kinds of stuff in there. There is a limit, so pay attention. Now, when you go up to the car in the front, if you want to hit E, you will start accessing the front hood and you will get the vehicle mechanics menu. This menu is super important because we can uninstall, repair, install. We can also take a look at everything the car might need, and it'll tell you what you need to do if you want to uninstall or repair these parts. So you're going to have to read manuals, raise your mechanical skill, and collect tools. So this is where hoarding comes in handy, and my favorite thing to do. You'll need wrenches and tire irons, tire pumps, things like that, if you want to have a fully functioning car and maintain it, because the muffler, the tires, the engine, the battery, all these things wear down as you're using it. If you run out of gas, no worries. You can actually steal gas. You can siphon gas from other cars and put it into your car if you have a gas canister. So that's super duper helpful when you find those raggedy cars off on the side of the road. Not only do you have these mechanical options when you're inside your car, but you can also sleep in your car. You can roll down the window. Why is that important? Well, because did you know that you can get hot inside of your car? And if you have the window up, then it's gonna be hotter. Roll down the window and you'll notice that your temperature will go down. You can also turn on and off the AC and the heater. So that's all I know about cars. This is very basic, and I hope it was helpful. If it taught you anything, leave me a thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you're having a super fun time in Project Zomboid. If you have any questions, and I know it, I will try to answer, but only if you leave me a comment letting me know what's up, what it is you're looking for. That way I can help. All right, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate each and every one of you. I'm Zombie Girl, and I will see you later. Bye.